What's going on, everyone? This is Yarn from Orange Juice.
Hi, guys. It's Mana from Orange Juice. And today, we got a 1,000-player tournament for you guys.
So, it's all brought to you by Mastery GG, so yeah. It wouldn't have been possible without them.
Yeah,
they really awesome. We'll probably be bringing some more, thanks to them, just because of that.
So yeah,
it's really awesome that they're doing this.
It's smaller payouts from what it was before, but hey, if you got time to spare, it'll be fun. You can try out new decks. Try out the new Mega Minion if you guys have a deck.
Yeah, it's slightly overpowered right now.
Slightly. I think it's okay. I think it's alright.
Until people learn to counter it, at least.
Oh, it's easy to counter. I think it's harder to use. But, yeah, we'll see. It would be cool to see some.
Yep.
Before we get started, let's go check out the Mastery GG website, just to show you guys what it's all about. It's a website, it's personal coaching. And you're drinking, like, invisible stuff, man.
That's cool.
Cool. So yeah, right there. They're just like online coaches. So right now they just have Clash Royale, the 6 coaches on there. And what you can do is you can either send in your replay or do live coaching. And it kind of just helps you with your gameplay here and there. And there's a whole variety of them. So here's one from or here's one of the coaches, Isopa. He actually played in the last tournament you hosted, right?
Yeah, he was there. Yeah. He did pretty well. I think he was running Trifecta.
I don't remember. No, he was running a.
That was another time then.
But yeah, it was really cool. He did really well. And yeah, it's really cool to check out. If you want to check it out, just do !mastery in Twitch chat, and you'll be able to see that. But that's it for now. And yeah, let's get back here.
Yeah, so the thing is pretty cool because what they do is you submit a replay and then they kind of just outline everything, kind of like sports plays where they'll correct you if your play could have been improved here or there and all that stuff. And Woody is one of the coaches, which is really cool because he's one of the best players. He's won the most Super Magical Cups.
Ooh, thanks for the subscribe, Glow Toxic.
Glow Toxic, thank you for that.
Awesome. We'll be releasing the password in a little bit. Just need to check some things out first. You want to jump into a game or anything? Or do you want to do it right now? In a couple minutes. I'm gonna set a timer.
Let's go right now. There's a lot of people that...
Are they?
Yeah.
Oh, cool. So we're going to be changing the password to...
This isn't the password yet.
Yeah.
So we will announce the password
in 3 minutes after we show it. Put it down. I'll put it on a timer, and then we'll spam it in chat as well. But the password is going to be Meow4. Meow4. All lowercase, guys.
So don't enter that in right now because you'll be locked out of the tournament.
So, and the tournament name. If you just search Mastery, GG, or Orange in the search bar, you'll be able to find our tournament there.
Yeah. I'll hop into a game right now before we change the password, so we'll just kind of let everyone catch up. By the time I'm done the game, we'll kind of have a countdown in chat. We'll give you guys 10 seconds.
I'll give them 30 seconds.
30 second heads up.
Yeah. So the password will be Meow4, but after this game, we'll give you 30 seconds. Just try to find it in chat right now. It's not changed yet, so don't spam it, because you guys might get knocked out.
So this is going to be my first time running this deck. It's really popular.
Oh, you're doing a Grand Challenge. I thought you were doing a ladder.
I've never used the giant deck.
Oh, good luck.
This kind of giant deck. We'll see how I do. It's got the Mega Minion in there. It's the one that everyone's using right now. Bonecat's used it today with
Oh, cool. Ooh, he looks like he's going to cycle you. You should have put the... Oh, I see what you wanted to do. Save your pump.
Don't want to poison that.
I think you're okay. You might have a princess, so you might save it for that.
YOLO.
Oh, Lava Hound. But you got a Mega Minion, so it's all good.
Why is he laughing?
You can squelch him if you want.
Nah.
The name of the tournament, if you just type in orangemastery.gg, it will be there. I'll type out the tag for you guys, too. Hey Yari, can you get a shout out? Asian Master 7.
Oh dear, it's because I used my poison.
I told you. Tournament tag.
That's why he laughed.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Yeah. It's still pretty good though. Still a lot of time left. He'll probably pump. Or he'll want to pump. Oh, did it actually get in?
Yeah. Oh yeah.
One hit.
He's gonna reach 10 elixir really soon, so he'll be at an advantage.
Mm-hmm. That's true.
Oh, he's not gonna miner this time, so he's gonna go full force.
Yeah, so he'll have all his air. As long as he can get to your poison, you should be fine.
He's gonna back up with a musketeer soon, right there.
You have a bowler to deal with a log air deck. Bad. Cool. Oh, you're getting some punches in. And Boulder's doing pretty good too.
This guy is really aggressive.
Yep. It's that extra pump. But he oh, okay. Yeah, password will be Meow4. All lowercase though. All lowercase. There's no uppercase in there. Is it first time playing this deck? Yeah, right?
Yep, I have no idea what I'm doing.
you're doing alright. Yeah, name a tournament to search Orange Mastery. It's on the bottom right, or bottom left hand corner. Sorry. Try to search for there. See? Mega Minion, man. He's really slow.
No, I'm not using him right. He's a lot better than this.
Maybe it's just because of the deck, who knows?
No, this deck is really good. I'm just really using it poorly.
Yeah.
Because I've been using that cycle deck all morning. I played like 100 games, so my mindset's really off right now.
Yeah, it's a slower.
Yeah.
And barbs. It's the first time seeing barbs.
Second time.
Oh, I've been paying attention.
Yeah.
I've been doing other things. He's gonna chip you out, man.
Very slowly. That barbarian is gonna get it.
Yeah. Good game. Cool. So, game over. Yeah, you still got two chances. You can chances get through that a bit later. But yeah, we'll start a 30-second countdown now. Again, password. Is Meow4. All lowercase. And we'll be spamming it in chat. Or countdown in chat. So in 30 seconds. Oh, wrong way. Timer.
Let's turn off the...
Turn off what? Lost 30 minutes. Yeah. Sorry. Let's give us some more time.
Can hey, I donated too. OJ with almost thanks. Trophies, Kappa.
Elgato.
There it is. Sorry, I'm gonna turn this off for a little sec. For a little bit.
So the password will be Meow4.
All lowercase. Okay.
Let's do countdown on the chat.
Okay. I'm gonna turn it back on. So that's fine.
Yep.
Yeah.
I'll do a 10 second countdown.
Okay.
You do that on Twitch?
Yep.
Alright, let's do it.
Alright. 10. 6. 5. 4. 3. 2. 1. Good luck, everybody. Meow4, all lowercase. 144, 383. Still a lot of space, guys. If you have time to do it tonight, go for it. Oh, I better turn that off too. Yeah, thanks for all that, Glow Toxic. Subscribe and donate it.
Oh yeah, it's pretty hard to get in.
We'll have some Koreans here, he can help you out with that.
He manages all the clan stuff, but you apply at bit.ly/OJsign. There's already a huge queue. Mm-hmm. We don't necessarily measure by scale, we just kind of like grow with a family.
Yeah.
So I don't really care about your trophy range as long as you're in Legendary. Just and like just pretty... the fact that it shows that you're more active, you know?
Yeah. And being nice doesn't hurt, right? tournament full. Sweet.
Alright, awesome. Let's get started.
Yeah, so good luck to everybody in the tournament. And thanks again to MasteryGG for sponsoring this tournament for us.
Wouldn't be possible without them. It's pretty awesome.
Yeah. So it's try out some new decks if you guys want. And we'll be showcasing some people here.
I'm gonna hop into challenge really quickly, just kind of
get the challenge
get the leaderboard settled in.
I guess so. Spectating mode is cheating. I've never seen that before.
Yeah, it can be.
Does it work?
Yeah, because if your friend spectates,
yeah,
then they can see your opponent's elixir and their card rotation.
Oh, I see. Cool. Not cool. Sorry. Oh, you switched your deck back to your cycle deck.
I wasn't ready for it.
Ouch. That's gotta hurt. Thoughts on the new cards? Mega Minion?
For the other cards? They'll come eventually. For the Mega Minion, that's... I think it's slightly overpowered. Just slightly.
What makes you say that? His damage or his health?
Because he can one-shot pups.
Yeah.
Minions. All those guys.
Yeah.
So he's very good defensively. And in terms of offense, he's really well with the Giant Golem.
Oh, I see.
And Lava Hound.
Yeah. Cool. Somebody asked, Mark V11, what video editor do you use?
We use Adobe Premiere.
Premiere, yeah.
And After Effects.
Sometimes.
Yeah.
Sometimes. But yeah, Adobe Premiere. Really cool. So we already got some winners up in the tournament. Julian, first place, first win. Well, there's a whole bunch of them. Booty Warriors up there. Marin. Blacklist asked, do you like the Mega Minion more than the Ice Spirit?
I don't like the Mega Minion, it's not my playstyle. It's like, it's good, but it just doesn't suit me.
Hmm. You're the only reason people use the Ice Spirit. No, I think people just aren't used to it yet.
Yeah, it was just, what's going on here?
You're getting pushed. That Mega Minion, it's still alive, like full health. Let's gotta take that tower, man.
Oh, 10 seconds left.
Yeah.
What was the question? It was,
you said you're the reason that people start using Ice Spirit.
No, that's not true, because when I released that video, what happened was, the top 200 players were all using Ice Spirit. There was like a 60% use rate, so.
Yeah.
It was still pretty high, just people didn't realize how to use him at the time.
Yeah, he's actually really good. Yep. I wish I could replace him in my deck, but he's not high enough level yet. But yeah, let's go back to the tournament. See what you guys are playing.
As Bodler in number one.
Ooh, Giant.
30 seconds into the match, he's got a Giant Elixir Collector.
Hmm.
My money is that he has poison in there somewhere.
There's a witch, and it looks like a trifecta on the other side.
Yep.
Cool.
Mini Picket goes in, but the hog's still gonna slide through.
Yeah.
So that's gonna deal a lot of damage, because he's overcommitted with the Mitch, with the witch on the left side quite a bit.
Yeah, but he should be able to get some damage onto the other tower.
Yeah, it looks like that cannon's not gonna stop the witch from that, so...
Yep. Archers. That's pretty cool. Hmm. So the rest of trifecta, zap. And I don't remember. I'm drawing a blank. Pump. Yeah, there it is.
I didn't leak anything.
What? Orange Spirit? Orange Spirit confirmed?
Yeah, exactly.
He's going for a giant push. Yeah, so far we haven't seen this a spell from Showboulder.
Spodler?
Spodler?
I'm gonna call him Spodler.
Spodler. Zap, poison, freeze?
Looks like it could be a zap poison.
Ooh, if you had lightning, that'd be kinda cool. Lightning would do really well. Take out that cannon, go straight for it. Can you do damage to the musketeer? Can it kill the musketeer at tournament standards? Or just really low?
Lightning... It was like 600?
600? Oh, cannon! Good.
That's a very different deck that Spodler's running.
Yeah, I like it. He has like all like the basic cards right there.
Yeah, with Pam Tom? Amb Tom? he hasn't had any reason to use a zap yet, so that's his 8th card that we haven't seen yet.
Yeah. But he has a Valkyrie, and that deals like, yeah, it's awesome against the Witch.
30 seconds into the game, and we still haven't seen much done.
Yeah.
Oh, with the pig push, it looks like it's gonna bypass that cannon, so he should have planted it one tile on the other side.
That's that. That's good. Well, it looks like you're in for a long one. HP 30. Oh, thanks for tweeting for that stream. Or, our stream. Awesome. Do you know the chance of what legendary chest would appear in the shop? Or when? Maybe like once a month or something, right?
Yeah.
Hard to say.
It should be about once... at least once a month.
That makes sense.
The epic chest is around once a week.
Yeah.
Give or take.
But we don't really know. It's only been like the first week, has it?
Yeah.
Yeah, first week of stuff.
Looks like he couldn't get through the giant push with his the trifecta deck, just that cannon kept pulling it.
Yep. It's really tough. So we got some new people up there. Joshua, Aro, Beast.
I'm gonna turn off the password.
Yep. Anybody can join if there's free space. But lots of time left.
Yep. Let's hop into a really quick match.
Oh, cool. Lumberjack will still be able to take her out? Almost. With that giant. Cool. He might be running minions too. Who knows? Or it could be the same deck. We'll know who has a pump. So that might be his next play right there. He's waiting for that pump. Yarn, do you prefer Ice Wizard or Princess?
I prefer the Princess. I used the Ice Wizard for a month and it's way too defensive. I wonder why he zapped.
I don't know.
I'm just gonna send in goblins now he doesn't have zap.
Yeah, maybe... Oh, he didn't give up. Guards. He'll probably have point... Oh, there's the pump. He wanted to get rid of your miner.
My miner?
Or bait out the miner, right? Mm. So he can plant his... Oh, he went for the tower instead. Ouch. Here comes a... kind of giant coming up soon. Yeah.
That's gonna deal way more damage than I want.
Yeah. A lot of damage.
Yeah, that witch is still alive. It's gonna take out my tower now.
You'll be alright. Did he zap? Nah. Would it be worth it to log him back?
It was because I think I played my princess for no reason.
Oh, you wanted to get rid of the splash that was coming.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Those archers might be able to take it out. Pretty close. Pretty close.
I didn't need to zap there.
That's okay. You'll probably be able to take out that tower, actually. Now, he doesn't have a witch for push. But he still have his giant, so he's gonna throw that. He might throw a miner, too. Oh, a Sparky. That's new.
That's a surprise.
Don't mess up.
I messed up.
Oh. We got Ice Spirit.
I have to Ice Spirit it.
Yeah. It's tough that goblins are around.
I meant to log that. Did I misclick or did that just kind of lag out?
Oh, I wasn't paying attention. I was trying to read chat. We like the new update, Asian Master 7.5. I think it's pretty cool. Going to overtime. Pretty even. You probably put the giant down. Should have his witch soon too. But he might just save for a Sparky. Yeah. A log would have been good there.
That's weird that he pumped up.
Oh. Yeah, sometimes you're in the moment.
Yeah. Good game for that. I had a lot of misplays there. I think I was reading chat.
Yeah, you get distracted.
Yeah.
Very easily.
Whatever, I don't take it seriously when I stream.
Cool. So Joshua's up first. Andrew's up there. Oh, got that. Hey, it looks like that deck you were trying to run.
Yeah, except he's playing it properly. He's got the Mini Pekka in place of the Musketeer, so they both kind of function the same high DPS cards. The only difference is that without the Musketeer, it doesn't have the same anti-air measures.
Yeah. But you still got rocked by anti-air, or by an air deck.
Yeah.
Cool. So yeah, still a lot of time, 48 minutes left.
Alright, let's lose my third challenge.
Alright. Someone's saving up for gold. Should we get a log or a princess?
Princess is a lot better. The log is really awesome, but it's completely different.
I think it works for like specific decks. Good for cycle.
Whereas the princess works for everything.
Yeah.
Very strange fireball.
Barbs. Giant? Royal Giant? Yarn, are you gonna make another tournament? No, just this one tonight, guys. Oh, hog.
Oh, misclick.
So what do you play? Barbs? Oh, I had Fireball. That was the strange thing. So I'll probably Fireball your Princess again. Or Pump Up.
I can dig that.
There it is. Fireball? I saved this time. That tower's gonna go.
They both gonna go.
Go hog now. But you have like, oh, a freeze. If you could meet a legendary in real life, which one would you want to meet?
I met the princess in real life in Korea. It was a really good cosplay.
Oh, a cosplay?
Yeah.
I meet the log, but I probably met him already.
I was supposed to lose this match. I wanted to start a new challenge.
Oh, well, too late now. You gotta go for broke. At least get two so you break even, right?
Oh yeah. I should do that.
Yeah. So Joshua's still first place, playing that, Bowler Giant Poison? Beast is still up there, R07.
Oh dear.
Novi. He'll be alright.
Yeah, I missed Zap and misplayed the Princess, but...
Ice Spirit fixes everything.
Yeah, it does.
Yeah. Good game.
No, he might get this tower because I'm too relaxed right now. I was kind of hoping that he would win.
Yeah.
So we have 44 minutes left in the tournaments. We'll probably be hosting some more tournaments.
In the future.
Yeah. The tournaments are all brought to you by Mastery GG.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Joshua is still number one.
Yeah, it's solid, man.
Yep.
Super solid. Ooh, so close. That was a good freeze. Alright, Ice Spirit.
I'll play a few matches here and there, but I like to spectate. It's a nice little break. I think I played 100 games this morning. I got 2,000 challenge cards.
It's a lot, man.
So I'm pretty tired from playing.
Yeah, this one's just for you guys.
What is Mastery GG for? It's a website, kind of like for e-coaching. So
yeah,
you send in your replays and they kind of like coach you and what you could have done better and all that stuff.
Yeah, so it kind of improves your gameplay. They only have Clash Royale right now, but they're looking to expand to Vainglory. I think League of Legends was on there.
Yeah.
There's another game on there, but we'll visit the website. We'll show you the website again to see what other games they have planned. Right. But yeah, it's like, if you're having trouble and you want to get some extra help, like a new set of eyes can kind of help you with that. And that's what Mastery GG is for. Cool. Yeah, man, Josh is doing awesome. So solid.
Did the super magical chess cycle reset? To my knowledge, it did not, because it only reset once when it went from 1,000 to 500, so that it stayed at 500, it should be the same.
Yeah. Has anybody gotten a legendary chess yet in chat?
Let's watch Joshua, this time from the very beginning. Whoa, calm down, HK, calm down.
Well, HK's got you guys, right? There you go.
Yeah. Joshua in with the Mega Minion, level 7 tournament standard already.
He probably got the deal. It was a pretty good deal.
150 gems?
Yeah. Yeah, for like 100, it was almost tournament standard there.
I played a lot of challenges to get. I opened the 12 win chest,
yeah,
and it had like 60 Mega Minions, so that brought me up pretty fast.
Dang.
For 100 gems, that's such a good value.
It is. Oh, someone's got a legendary and an epic? Cool, man.
I think they're back to back. I don't know the exact cycle.
Yeah, I don't know either. Yeah, we'll just have to wait and see. It's been like a week, so it's very hard to see.
But we've had like hundreds of people on Twitter saying that they got them back to back.
That's pretty cool. Yeah. It can't be a coincidence that many people have got it.
Yeah. Look at that Mega Minion just slowly go through. He zapped it, it's gonna get one hit in.
Yeah.
Two hits.
That's a lot of damage.
Yeah. What's that, 500? A little bit over 500 damage.
Yeah. He's super strong.
That was a value zap. Joshua knows how to play Mega Minion. This is
cool. It's education for everybody, right?
Yeah.
Inferno Tower, he has it there. But see, the Mega Minion, it's a little slower.
Mine is zapped Inferno Tower right there.
Yeah.
And Mega Minion just destroys it.
Yep, he's still alive.
Yeah.
Right. The Mini Peck is going in. One, two.
In that sense, because the Mega Minion's not zappable, it's kind of better for countering the Inferno with the Giant, because you can use Fire Spirit's Princess Zap to take care of the regular minions, but the Mega Minion just goes straight to the Inferno Tower.
Yeah. It's really awesome. It's a cool card. I like it. Okay, he's going in for that push. See, the cool thing like I like about the Mega Minion is it stays so long in the field that it can just defend a whole bunch of stuff.
Is that his rage? No, it's not. Two Mega Minions, that's the thing, is that they die so fast. They're the glassiest glass cannons in the game right now.
That's true.
He's doing pretty well with this defensive-wise right now.
Yeah.
That one Mega Minion's just taking everything out.
Yep. He's still alive.
The zap didn't kill it. That's bad news for the X.
That's value, right there. I have another Inferno. But the other side's gonna get taken down. Oh! Almost.
That Giant is gonna get a couple punches in, that's a good game for that.
That's all you need.
Look at that, he used the Mega Minion defensively when possible.
That's probably one of the best ways to play
it. And then he used it offensively to counter the Inferno Tower.
Yeah.
Just because the Giant was equally slow.
It's like textbook right there. Oh, I got a new number 2, Novi. New number 3, too. Ha!
Look at all these triple musketeer guys.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Cool. Let's go check one out. Extreme Dinosaur. I like that name. He's doing pretty well too. Oh, a Sparky deck. Sparky Goblin.
You already revealed the Sparky, I wonder why. Usually...
Oh, it depends on your hand, right?
Yeah. Looks like he didn't have anything to counter.
Oh, he's just like... sitting on Elixir right now. Oh, there you go.
Leg.
Could be.
Yeah.
There's the Sparky. But Nobi does have things to deal with it.
Ice Spirit to absorb the blast or zap.
Yep.
Poison has a 20% slow, so it'll actually, once the Sparky discharges, it'll take another 20.
Yeah, Ice Wizard as well. Ooh, good luck.
Oh, going in for that zap bait. But the Ice Wizard did pretty well in defending against the Goblin Barrel.
Ooh, that was value.
Yep. That took out, what, 9 Elixir?
Yeah.
Well,
oh,
that took
here
out.
It comes.
That's the thing with Sparky is sometimes it's just there so you can
kind of like
force your opponent to overreact to the Sparky.
Yeah,
and there are other things. Like, it looked like Goblin Barrel did a lot more damage.
Yep.
The Sparky's just there to bait for zap.
Yeah, it just threatens you. It's on the field, right?
It's really scary.
But yeah. This will go into overtime. He can zap that tire. Or poison that tire. You shouldn't zap.
Kappa.
Oh, Toxic. 2 donations
Ooh,
today.
Toxic? What's that?
I can't read that. but thank you. Wow, 2 donations and a subscribe.
He's testing us.
We failed. Thank you so much. Oh, look at that. That, in the pocket right there. Triple Musketeer.
Yeah,
it's... annihilated it. But yeah,
he did have Zap and the Log and Fire Spirits to take care of that, but looks like he didn't reserve for that.
Yeah. Yeah, good game. Sweet.
And that's why Novi is in number 1 now.
Awesome. Oh, Joshua's right behind him, though.
Let's jump into a game really quickly. I haven't been in one in a while. I'm gonna plant the Ice Spirit last, but in front of the Lumberjack, so it jumps in front.
Ooh.
Uh-oh.
Oh, he's right.
He's gonna zap me and it's gonna deal like 1,000 damage. I'm done.
They're alright. That's fine.
I got lucky there. I overcommitted.
Yeah, you used most of. You still had the Log, so you're able to push him back if it needed to.
I wouldn't
to.
Have done much.
Yeah. Cool. So he's a hog. And. Oh, Royal Giant.
Uh oh. That's gonna push it. Almost push it out of range.
It did.
I'm gonna have to Ice Spirit this now.
Oh no.
I wonder why he left.
It's really frustrating to deal with that.
Probably because he saw the Inferno, I guess.
Yeah. Do you have any non-legendary decks other than Trifecta? Well, there's lots of giant push decks if that's more your style.
Technically, there's like the giant poison, but you have to have level 4 guards.
Giant witch is good. Right, you can do that without any legendaries, and it's pretty easy to get.
The bowler is more common now, though, so the
it's
bowler
a little
just
harder to get,
wrecks
though.
The witch really hard.
Yeah, that's true. Oh, good game. Good luck.
Oh, maybe no. He just disconnected.
Unfortunately.
Yeah.
Joshua's back up there.
Oh yeah.
Solid.
Tournaments are a little bit harder now.
Are they?
Yeah.
Or do you find it?
No. I mean, for getting even 5 cards, you're going to have to place in the top 200.
Oh, wow. That's not worth it for 5 cards, man. But it's good for practice.
Yeah, it's nice and casual.
Yeah.
Looks like Joshua and all these guys are going to be competing for the big boys, though. Mm-hmm. I can't... Honestly, I couldn't get number 1 with just how the tournament style works.
Yeah.
But I could get 12 wins and get 1,100 cards. That's a lot easier for me.
Mm. Yeah, well, the challenge mode kind of like, you just play at your own pace, right?
Yeah, it's more casual. I can just take a break.
Yep.
Oh, that's nice stuff.
Ooh, that was a good P.E.K.K.A. The Fire Spirits will take out that Mini P.E.K.K.A. Oh, but he counters with his own. That's good.
The Mini P.E.K.K.A. still goes in, though, for 1 hit.
Yeah.
Just 1 hit.
But he still has a Lava Hound pushing the other side.
Yep.
Oh, Inferno. That's the counter you're looking for.
He's gonna have Zap for all of that. Right there.
Good call. Still got two pups.
Those two pups are still gonna do so much damage.
I know, man. Just like poking away at it. Wow, I did a lot more than I expected.
That was a very desperate princess.
Yeah, we restarted now.
And what do you mean by restart? A lot of people don't understand what that means exactly.
Oh!
You're too advanced with your frame rate stuff from Street Fighter and all that stuff.
I have just general like gaming knowledge, but it's kind of like restarting the playing field, right? It's like after all the combos are all used, you just kind of go into this like back to like beginning.
Square one where everyone's right at the same card rotation.
Exactly. So I almost said mana. All the elixir.
It is mana.
All the elixir.
Fun fact, in the game file, it is called mana.
Yeah. So all the elixirs reset to what you started with. All the cards are restarted to the beginning. So that's why I call it like everything's restarted.
Yeah.
So we see if you guys will play the same cycle or you'll switch it up, kind of thing.
And sometimes you get stuck where you're both mirror imaging each other and playing the same cards and counters, but you find that every time you use that cycle, you're losing 200 health and you're not dealing any health.
Yeah.
A good way to get out of that cycle is to recognize what happens and just play some cycle cards. Like maybe you need to play Ice Spirit or Skeleton just to rotate out of that cycle.
Yep.
Other times you can just use different counters.
Yeah.
Or different tile positioning.
Yeah. Sometimes I just take the damage on one side and like don't use my counter and just go for the other one.
Yeah.
If it's small enough.
It really depends on the situation, but you have to recognize when you're stuck in that cycle and just reset it to your advantage.
Yep. Cool.
Kyle Freezy from Orange Juice.
Oh, he's from Orange Juice. Cool. Let's check him out.
He's playing that meta deck right now.
Yeah. Mini Pekka. Yeah. Same deck as Jastrow's. Oh, he has two giants on the field. Ouch.
Doesn't look like Batsy has any. Oh, he already played the Inferno. He must have already played the Inferno.
Yeah. But there's a Zap and there's a Poison, so it was able to get.
And the Mega Minion just one-shots the Princess. So broken.
He still might get a couple hits in. One hit? Yeah.
Yeah. But now they're even.
Yep.
Played the Mini Pack a little bit high.
Here comes Inferno. Guards will be played.
Very good on Batsy to use the Ice Spirit to pull the guards away from the Inferno.
Yeah.
So even if Kyle froze the Inferno with Zap.
Yeah.
The giant will still be targeted.
Right. And the Inferno will take out everything.
That was an amazing play on Ice Spirit. So small details like that makes a difference for a whole game.
Yeah, I wish we could have the replay so we can go back and like take a look at like where he actually played it.
Yeah. Asian Master 7, good night.
Oh, good night. Thanks for watching.
So let's see what Kyle's gonna change. He's gonna have. So Kyle is pumping up twice now.
Yeah, so he'll have like giants and giants and giants back to back. So if he can cycle to his giant.
If he can. Batsy. If he has guards to take care of that mini pack right now, it's gonna deal more than.
Yeah.
Not bad. Countered the miner for chip damage because right now he's at a 600. 500 health disadvantage, so he really needs to prevent all the chip damage he can.
Yeah, so that Mega Minion took all that Inferno damage. Right, and he's able to put down another giant soon, and just push for the tower. So that's how he won the game. He had like that elixir advantage.
Almost
won the game.
Yeah,
but he still has that pump.
Basically, he could just poison him out right now.
He could.
If I were Kyle, I'd just cycle between the elixir pump, zap, poison, and just defend. Oh, it looks like he's doing both pressuring and poisoning.
Yep,
very good call on that.
Yeah, poison really does a good job against the Inferno. Good game.
Awesome plays there. Batsy played very well.
Yeah.
That Ice Spear was amazing. I wish I had that kind of footage when I was making the Ice Spear video, but sometimes you just can't include everything.
If I included
every single situation, every single scenario, the video would get really stale and boring, and it'd be a 20-minute video about just...
Oh, you got to plant it here, plant it here.
Yeah, so I try to include the most basic stuff, just so you have an idea of everything.
Well, that's what we try to do, right? Yeah. We just kind of give you a general sense and let everybody kind of experiment and like, this is what it could do, and let's see what you guys can come up with, which is awesome.
That was the thing with when I played Clash of Clans, the whole reason why I was inspired by Orange Juice was just, I was really competitive in war.
Yeah.
And the war attacks, they would like go Lavaloon, Goho, all that Goho. That's so 2013.
I have no idea what you're talking about, but yeah.
Golem
yeah.
Hog.
Okay.
Yeah. So that stuff, you would see these 20 to 30 minute videos explaining how to do the attack.
Yeah.
And it's it was very slow paced, and I just couldn't sit through those 30 minute videos. So that kind of inspired why I wanted to make this channel.
Mm-hmm. Thanks for follow Squirtle.
Squirtle again?
Yeah. Well, it's spelled with a 1 and a 3.
Yeah.
cheapest way to counter Three Musketeers. Well, the good old Fireballs app still works really well.
Ice Spirit Guards work.
Oh, whoops. I forgot about those. Ice Spirit Guards?
Yep.
Yeah, but you have to have, like, higher level guards, right? Or would just, like, level 2 guards or level 1 guards be able to do
it? I haven't tested it. I always test everything at tournament standards.
Yeah.
But a tournament standard, it does shut down the... It can shut down the Musketeer completely. Yeah.
Sometimes I use, like, a tank on the side and I throw in Fire Spirits, it works. Which is fine. But then I have to use a Zap, too, so it's kind of, like, even. I run Poison to my deck, so I just use Poison Zap and it does a really good job.
Yeah, oh yeah. A really cool thing with Poison, too, is that if you have a Log Poison, you can actually just use the Log to push them back into the Poison.
Yeah.
Alright, let's see if Kyle can defend for another minute. He is currently in number 3 with 241 trophies. If he's going to win this game, he'll be placed in number 1 unless Joshua wins another game.
Yep. Which
looks like that might be the chance.
Yeah, with that giant balloon.
Yeah.
The accident beat the legendary. Yeah, we did. Norn Spirit.
Yeah.
That was our bad. Man, you guys are frame hunters, man. That one frame. Jesus.
Yeah.
Cool.
The Mega Minion video had his armor just in one frame. The armor. Who?
It wasn't even like, yeah, it was just like the very edge of it, wasn't it?
It was the very edge, cross-referenced with the leak and everything. Who has the time to...
That was pretty cool though. When I saw that, I'm like, wow, you guys are...
That's amazing. I'm done. I'm never doing sneak peeks again.
Yeah, they're gonna watch your like video like frame by frame now, just to find anything.
Yeah.
I'm just gonna throw things in there. What's your trophy best? Somebody asked. Headshots.
I don't really push. It's kind of stressful to push, so I just kind of chill and enjoy the game. I just play to get crowns.
Do you find that you're playing challenge more than regular?
A lot more, actually. It's a lot more rewarding.
Yeah.
Look at that. I was sitting at 1,600 cards this morning, and just from playing a few challenges, boosted up to 2,000.
Cool.
It's pretty sweet. It's if you're pretty decent at the game, it's such a huge feature. Like, there's no point to buy magical chests anymore. There's no point to buy any gold. Like, the challenge pays off immediately after the second win.
That's cool. Joshua's still up there. That solid deck. Kyle Freezy's up there too.
I gotta check out Kyle Freezy again.
Oh, they're playing Joshua.
Oh, this is gonna be a really good game. Number 1 versus number 3.
Yep.
Kyle Freezy's gonna be banned from orange juice if he loses.
No pressure, Kyle. No pressure.
Yep.
But yeah, let's sit in for this match.
You want me to do a challenge? I'll do a challenge, but I honestly I want to lose because I have way too many.
Yeah.
I want to lose because I have way too many losses already. Lost twice in the first game. Does the classic challenge still pay better than the shop? It does, because you're only paying 10 gems and it scales relatively the same as a grand challenge.
Oh, what were we talking about? The 10 gem one?
Yeah.
The
100? Artiga asked about the classic challenge. It still tastes better than the chop. Of course it does, in terms of 10 gems. Like,
yeah. But how much do you have to win to like kind of even out on that one?
Two.
Two? Same thing?
Yeah, because the reward is about 10% less, but you're only paying 10 gems.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it scales relatively the same.
Giants are going to high five. Sweet.
Is the guy on the right from Ethan, H3H3? What? You don't look like Ethan.
Who? What? I don't know who that is.
Just some other YouTuber.
Oh yeah? Cool.
So they're both pretty even right now. Joshua and Kyle playing the same deck. The exact same deck.
It's it is the same deck. I forgot.
Exact same deck. You're just going back and forth.
So what would be the key to like being able to? That's pretty key right there. Never mind. Like, what would be the key to like outpush each other if you're playing like the same deck?
Right? They're both at a stalemate right now.
Yeah, but
Kyle's at a bit of a disadvantage. Joshua's just constantly pressuring with that momentum.
Yeah, it was that one mega minion that was there. It kind of like instantly died
from the zap.
Yeah, zap and everything kind of surrounding it. So he wasn't really, didn't really do anything.
What's your favorite J. Cole song? Asked Soulja Boy.
J. Cole. Oh.
Don't even get him started.
No. But you got to go way back. Dead Presidents, one of my favorite. Lights Please, always a classic.
Looks like he's gonna get poisoned out.
Yeah.
Alright, we all know what we need to do.
You actually gonna do it? Oh.
No, I'm just messing with you guys. Let's jump into Gamer now. I haven't been in one in a while.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's what, 23 minutes left in this tournament?
Yeah. Cool. Yeah, we'll show you the Mastery GG site one more time. And yeah, if you guys want to check it out, just do !! Mastery GG in Twitch chat, and there's a link straight there. But yeah, thanks again. It was a really nice of them to help sponsor.
Yeah, we wouldn't have been able to do these tournaments without them. Honestly, it's out of our own. Whenever we do tournaments, it's out of our own pocket. So I'd probably host like a dinky 200-player tournament. Yeah.
But yeah, these tournaments are for you guys. Apply for oranges. Let me see if I can get the link for you.
Uh-oh.
How are you doing in your match?
He's a little underleveled. Level 3 bowler, level 2 minions, level 2 guards.
Yeah.
I'm gonna lose it anyways.
Where's HK? There you are.
Look at that, he planted the miner in the exact same spot. Oh, I planted my Inferno Tower one tile higher in hopes that it would target the bowler would target it, but I think my goblin still died.
This is a link? This one, right?
Yeah, bit.ly. / OG sign.
Oh, bit.ly. Okay.
It's really hard to join though, there's thousands of applicants, so.
Oh, okay.
And we only have like 5 clans, so there's not a lot of space. Look at this stuff.
Whoa! That's so cool. Yeah. Yeah, if you click that link, bit.ly/OJSign, there's the application form for trying to get into Orange Juice.
He keeps playing the miner on the side.
Same side?
Yeah. Like, if he attacks me on the left, he puts on the very side and on the right. Yep. It's always good to have a mental note of that. Some opponents don't change it up, so.
Right.
So, cool. Pretty cool.
Oh.
Yep.
Cool. So, Joshua's still up there. But yeah, let's do a little quick break. I just want to show you what the
Mastery GG is. Yeah, somebody earlier asked about what it was.
Yeah, so it's good to get to see
people that just joined.
We got to see what other games they had. So yeah, here's the website. If you go browse. Yeah, so the other game was Counter-Strike.
This just changed to coconut flavor.
it's an e-coaching site. Vainglory coming soon, League of Legends, Global Strike. But yeah, they don't have Clash Royale right now, and yeah, they have just a handful of coaches, and what you can do is you can submit your video, or you can do live coaching at the same time, or submit your video or do live coaching, And yeah, they'll help you out with your gameplays, kind of like, oh, you should probably use this here or use this here. Like that. And they have a really good, like, kind of whiteboard kind of thing. So they'll be able to draw onto your plate and saying like, oh, the placement should have been over here to the left a little bit more.
Or you should have played this card instead because you had this in rotation, mm-hmm. or you should have paid attention to their looks. I don't, yeah. like, kind of all that stuff.
Yeah.
And these guys are really good. Like, Woody has won the most Super Magical Cup tournaments to date. Isopa is, I think, part of Nova.
Yeah, he's solid, though.
He's one of their top players.
Yeah.
And Darth Jar Jar is part of Woody's clan.
Yeah. So yeah, you can go check out their, like, they all have their own profiles and, like, how they teach.
Yeah.
And everything's right on the site. So if you do !Mastery in the chat, they'll give you a link straight to Mastery GG. But let's get back over here.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. These guys are, like, some of the best players in the world.
Yeah.
There's Darth Jar Jar's profile. And this profile just speaks for itself. Look at how many cards he's won from the Classic Tournament. 32,000 cards.
Holy cow.
And then the challenge just came out, and he already has 6,000 cards.
That's a lot.
Let's see how active Woody's been. I don't think he's in. Yeah, there he is.
Yeah, Woody's been busy.
14,000 cards, and he's played a few challenges, and he's already at 2,000 cards.
Yep.
That's pretty awesome.
Ooh, it looks like Joshua lost a match. He's out of top four.
That's what I like about challenges, is that if I lose one or two, then I can still reach number 12 and still get 1,100 cards.
Yeah. Mastery costs money. Yeah. Each coach has its own fee, so you have to go check it out for there. Yeah, let's go check out one of the new guys.
Yeah, it might not be for everyone, but if you're into that, then it's pretty cool service.
It's nice to have a fresh eyes, like fresh set of eyes looking at your play sometimes, because sometimes you just keep doing the same thing over and over. I remember when I was playing, where I used to play a lot of Street Fighter, I used to do the same thing every single time, and I'd always lose. And then I had to take some time off and then kind of like review what I did wrong. And then eventually you just get better and better, and you stop making those like silly mistakes.
Oh, look at that, the guards snuck past the poison, so those guards did quite a bit of damage.
It's alright.
Ice Spirit to counter those barbarians.
And bowler.
To cycle back to the bowler.
Yeah,
not bad.
That was good. I wonder if he's running the same deck. Probably has a giant in there, hey?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. He's got the giant and zap, was it?
Guards. Right? You should have guards. On Ragers?
Rager? No, I think it's a zap.
Zap?
Really interesting because he's playing with a level 6 mega minion.
Yeah.
Still one shots a lot of stuff.
Oh,
Princess,
yeah.
All that stuff.
But look at it go.
Look at the damage. You can get it past the tower.
Yeah, if you can sneak it past, it does so much damage. Yeah. I like it.
It's like a slower minion that does more damage and doesn't die to fireball in one shot.
Yeah. So that's the cool thing. I think that's the best thing about the Mega Minion. Not being like, can't be arrowed, can't be zapped. Fire Spirits can tank. Can it tank all three? No, can't.
Yeah.
Can it?
It can survive three Fire Spirits.
Yeah. Oh, HK's favorite deck.
Look at that. He's going in with a balloon. He's not going to have any anti-air except for the Musketeer and Poison to take care of.
Oh, he has the Mega Minion.
But he didn't have the Elixir to deal with it, so it targeted the Giant instead.
One overtime. He has another pump on him, which is good. So we'll see if Rager can pull it out. Ooh. Fireball and zap.
What does STK really stand for? Soft Tissue Company, Shameful Traitors Plan, or Spooky Terrorist Killers? Make more quality OJ Flez, decap a cabra wealth.
Well, we do have a video in plan. STK is actually just a phone, like, phone company in Korea.
The clan is in the game too. What does the phone company stand for?
I don't know. I just know that it's a phone company in Korea.
we'll stick to the phone company.
Yeah.
That's pretty funny. I think they're part of HKE, so.
Are they?
Yeah.
Cool. Yeah, I don't keep up with any of that stuff.
I try not to either, so yeah. I don't like to climb.
Cool. Wow, pulled it out. That Mega Minion.
What happened there? I was kind of distracted with that donation.
Thanks for the donate,
from
though.
From Toxic.
yeah, it's just good Mega Minion value, being able to take out a lot of this stuff, and not being able to use his combo of Balloon.
Yeah, he kept sneaking past everything.
He's putting so much pressure onto the tower that he wasn't able to attack with Balloon. And if you just send in a giant, it's just not worth it, right?
Let's do something silly here. I'm gonna... Huh? Who needs a giant when I have triple musketeers? Yep. I don't know.
Alright, good luck. Rage is going in for another match. Still 13 minutes left. Angel's there.
I wish I thought this through. I need a miner in here.
Yeah. He's gonna target the miner, yeah. I mean, you need like some sort of tank. Oh, you have like quad musketeer?
Oh yeah, so I can split push. I didn't think this through, I just wanted to play triple musketeers.
I like triple musketeers, but mine are weak and I'm very bad at using them. That was good.
That was a bad zap.
Yeah, you didn't really need to zap. But you are ahead. I think he has a miner. Articuno fan approves. Cool. So we're just waiting now. Oh, Pekka. It'd be funny if he triple musketeered you back.
He doesn't have a pump, so...
That's true.
We would have seen that by now.
Yeah. Oh, someone got out of Royal Arena because of your video.
Sweet.
Let's see.
That's when the chests start getting really good.
Yeah, Spongy 9. Spongy 9. That's a good defense. Your Mega Minion would have been able to do more. Poison would be good.
Oh, he's got Wizard and Princess on the right side, so...
Ooh, that's all the splash he has. Still get a lot of damage on there. Can't believe that actually worked.
I really did need a miner for that, because I could have sent it in with the triple musketeer side.
Yeah. Yeah, congrats on getting a Royal Arena. Keep going.
Articuno in the house. One of the best triple musketeer players, too.
Yeah. Someone else got the legendary because of the video too. That's awesome. That's the main reason you started making it too, right? Just help everybody out.
It's pretty awesome. I've always been really knowledgeable about general game mechanics when I played Diablo, Dota.
Yeah.
Corpse Decay is 45 seconds, Double Pull Creep at 53 seconds, all that stuff. And it's really cool that I can kind of share my random knowledge now to the world.
Yeah, that's cool. I mean, yeah, if you guys get better, then we're doing our job right, which is awesome.
Don't quote me on that, like Dota 2 might be a little different, but that's what the mechanics are for Dota 1.
It's different now, and there's different positions for the camps too.
Yeah?
Yeah, there's extra camps as well, so it's pretty cool.
I just gotta cycle back to my zap, I guess.
Someone got the frozen peak because of the zap video. I like that video, that was a cool video.
Yeah, that took me like 4 days of editing, there's so much going on.
But that was cool because you just asked your clanmates for like zap replays for that one.
I think that was one of my best ones yet. Yeah. It was one of the most organic replays ever.
That's awesome.
That didn't work out. I'm not comfortable with that.
Did you win?
Yeah.
Oh jeez.
But it was
that's 10 minutes
left. It was only because he played Wizard and Princess.
Joshua climbed back up. Oh man. Even with that one loss. Back up there. Such a good deck.
Do I think that Inferno Dragon is going to change the giant meta a little bit? I'll release a video and go into detail about it, but
yeah,
it's very different. Like
it is different.
If you YouTube the leaks, it just shows him being deployed. It doesn't show how he's truly used. It's completely different from what everyone thinks.
We'll be working on that too. Trying to figure stuff out here and there.
Yeah. A lot of the time too is that we're not posting videos every single day because sometimes, like for these sneak peeks, it takes time to research all that stuff. And
yeah,
me and him are playing back and forth just to like.
We just get on each other's nerves.
Yeah.
We're like, man, why'd you do that? You just get frustrated at each other. But yeah, we're trying our best. We're not like pros at the game, we're just like, we're average.
I'm a scrub.
I'm worse. But yeah, we try to come up with like cool things, try to research different decks and
new ways to use them.
Oh no, look at that. The Lava Hound is tanking so much.
It's gonna be a lot of damage.
Now the balloon's tanking for the
pups. But poison, man. Poison's good.
Still, that still did over 1300 damage.
Yeah.
Just in one push. Now he's gotta face the Wrath of the Musketeer Giant counter push.
But he did put a pump down, which was great. Because he's able now, he has Elixir to defend. If he didn't have that pump up, he'd be in bigger trouble than he is right now.
That wasn't a bad defense. He only lost, like, what, 700?
Yep. But both of them aren't running buildings except for Elixir pump.
Boone, so you were in first place in a 200-man tournament, then you tilted last 10 minutes and got to 17th. That's what I don't like about these tournaments. Yeah. I love challenges. You can just kind of walk away and just consistently get 10 wins, 12 wins, all that stuff.
Yeah.
What's that? Oh. Cool. Push on push. Let's see who's gonna.
The guards really destroyed that prince. But the poison will do really well against this.
That balloon's still gonna get through though.
Yeah. Yeah, the musketeer needed to target the balloon in the back, but it's kind of hard. Like, you have to wait so long for it, but by the time you waited, it's like whatever. Sometimes you want to take the lava pup damage just to get the right positioning, I think.
Yeah.
Or the lava hound, sorry. Lava Hound
damage. This is actually not looking too bad right now if you can get those two musketeers in, but that bomber's. Bomber gets taken out.
Yeah. So, yeah, a couple zaps. Or Princess Fire will do that.
Challenges are pretty chill. It's, Blizzard was onto something when they came out with the arena mode for Hearthstone.
Yeah.
I'm really glad they implemented that idea.
Oh! Wow.
64. The only problem now is that Lord doesn't have.
Yeah, there you go.
There we go. He's cycled back into zap.
Yep. 64, that's like just
that's
the right.
That's exactly enough.
Yeah, the exact amount, isn't it? Yeah.
It is. It's.
Wow.
Joshua, number two, he's been consistently.
That's what I like to see, man.
He's probably at a 12-1 record right now.
Something like that.
7 minutes left into the tournament.
Yeah, Panda the Great, that's new. G-Sam. Yeah. Angel's still, like, hovering around top five, which is really cool.
Yeah, we'll probably be hosting a few more tournaments different days.
Yep. Not tonight.
It's a lot easier to do it now, and it's all going to be brought to you by Mastery. Wouldn't have been possible with them. I want to thank them again for that.
Yeah.
I want to play a Lava Hound deck. I haven't played that in a while. Anyone have a Lava Hound?
You just watched one.
I don't know how I feel about Minion Horde, Fireball. It's not my playstyle.
Well, Panda the Great just jumped into the match. You want to check him out?
Sure, let's do that. 6 minutes left in the game. It's going to be a very close match. So right now, Joshua is in the lead at 366.
Yeah, Panda's right behind him with 361.
Or, what's his face? Laksha is at 366. Joshua is at 311.
Yeah, really close. But we'll see what happens after this. That's gonna do a lot of damage. A lot of damage. We'll see if he has anything to defend the other
side. Those barbarians, they did nothing.
Yeah.
Value Ice Beard right there.
Someone's been watching your videos. Wow.
It was really great timing on that because the Ice Beard dies to two shots.
Yeah.
So he waited for one musketeer to target it, then.
Yeah. Then he planted
absorbed the other musketeer. That's amazing tech.
That's optimal right there.
Yeah. That was a huge positive elixir trade right there.
Yeah, just waiting now. Just pumping up. Oh, a P.E.K.K.A. Very expensive cards. Barbs, triple musketeer, P.E.K.K.A.
Yeah. But they were both playing pumps.
Yeah. But the thing is, like, Hatchie's deck, even if it's like he's down a one tower, he can come back really, really hard.
Oh, spaghettis. That giant's gonna get rocked so hard right now.
Yeah. So this is it. If you're able to build up this big push, the barb's on the other side as well.
That ice spirit did nothing.
Yeah.
It actually did decent. Took out the musketeer. Now you can kind of handle it.
Oh, three barbs over there. Yeah. That was a little mispull.
I think he meant to plant the giant a little bit higher up.
So he can grab all of the barbs. It was a little bit of a misplay.
Yeah.
And he already uses zap, so he knew he can send in his gobs to finish off that tower.
Pumping up at the cost of losing that tower to spear goblins. Hazard says, that he won 11,000 cards and only had one legendary. That's really unlucky because there's Yeah, if you open an 1100 chest, there's a 22% chance of a legendary. So
yeah.
Yeah, just
oh,
don't buy any scratch tickets. Hazard. That's all I can say.
Yeah. Too nervous to play. I'm waiting for a legendary chest, to be honest. I think that's more value for me at the moment.
Why don't I play skeletons? I do play skeletons. Mikan's deck has skeletons in there, it's amazing.
That's a cool deck. That's a hard deck to play against.
Yeah.
Because, you just kept always in my face with the hog, so I couldn't really do anything.
I've gotten two legendaries from the Grand Challenge, and I've only won 3,600 cards.
Hmm.
RNG on my side.
Yeah. That's for sure.
Hatchy with triple musketeers, he could plant it in center right now. But.
Oh, he went straight for the tower. Yeah. That bowler. And poison.
He's gonna get poisoned out if he doesn't do something in the center. But look at that, the bowler planted. That was possibly a bowler prediction plant, because he knew he was gonna plant the musketeers there.
Yeah, so just the poison will take it now.
Yeah.
He could have planted the musketeer in the pocket, right? And just to do it. And there it is.
That is a good game with 2 minutes left. Panda wins, going into... Let's see if he goes into first place now.
Second. Is that second?
Dang. So this is the most critical point in the tournament, where if... No, actually, Panda could still lose one and still rank number three, or still stay in number two rank.
That's true.
So...
But, I mean, 1,200 cards, not bad.
Yeah.
Like, at this point, so I'll stay. Because if Lakshya loses, then Panda's first, right? Yeah, he's first.
Yeah. So Panda might just be waiting to see what Lakshya does, or just be chill with 1,200 cards.
Either way, it's a win-win for Panda. Yep. Joshua's third. Really solid placement in this tournament. Really cool.
Who's going with Lava Loon? I'm going for the Prince push. That's just more volatile, and it's
well, the giant's faster. Still like full health.
Yeah,
that was a good Ice Spirit, but there's not enough damage to clean it up.
Oh, with the Mega Minion, the Mini Pekka, and the Prince, those Spear Goblins didn't do anything.
Yeah, I think he's going for the three.
That was a very desperate arrow.
Oh, he arrowed. Yeah, here it goes. That was a quick match.
The giant is still going on. Alright, so looks like Panda jumped into a match based on that outcome.
I guess he's going for it.
Yep.
408, I've never seen a 408 in a tournament before.
That's insane, he looks like he has like 100% win rate. That's what I like about challenges, you can lose twice, still win 1100 cards.
Yeah. It's more your style, eh? It's my style too.
It's not stressful, I like to enjoy the game.
Yeah. It's a fun game. Reminds me of the old StarCraft days. Custom maps.
Sheebs, you want me to do a video on the bomb tower? I did that 4 months ago.
We have an old video on the bomb tower.
It's still relevant.
Yeah.
Just instead of 60 seconds, it's 45 seconds.
You gonna let that rock? You gotta let it rock. I guess they can afford to because he has our panda has like the giant, right? So they can still push forward.
Oh, going in with that. He does have Zap as his final card and it is in rotation right now.
Yeah, so tournament's ended. Right now. Mishalaksha from Clout, I think it said.
Yep.
First place,
but it's going to depend on the outcome of panda.
This match, yeah.
This is such a close match. If he wins this match...
It'll be okay.
No, even if he wins, he's not going to get more than 30 trophies. So
he's sitting comfortable.
Even if he wins or loses, the outcome is going to be the same for Panda.
Yeah.
Either way, 1,200 cards. Not bad.
Joshua's still in the game too, though.
Yeah.
So we'll see if he moves up to third place.
This is such a tight match for Joshua.
Yeah.
Well,
Traveler's sneaked up into fifth.
Yeah.
He's new. So yeah, check out those decks out.
Han is doing something different going in on the right side this time, changing it up. Might lose that tower from that Lumberjack. Just crept right through.
Yeah, that was a really good poison. He got damage on the Musketeer, slowed it down, so he wasn't able to kill it fast enough. And able to get damage on the Elixir Pump. And a Sparky's just rolling in.
We don't work for a Mastery GG. They just kind of sponsored these tournaments, so.
Yeah. So it's really cool of them. They kind of just reached out to us and say, oh, like to sponsor a couple tournaments here and there. Wow, yeah, double giant.
Look at that.
Oh my god.
That's going to be enough momentum to go for a 3 crown, possibly.
Guy doesn't have enough HP.
Yeah, he has no anti-air for those minions, so it's going to shred everything.
Yeah.
Look at that, the Lumberjack's gonna get really distracted by the bowler. So.
That was really funny. The bowler pushed the Lumberjack like close enough to the giant so it'd do like a couple damage to it.
And then went back to the bowler.
Yeah. But yeah, wow. Great job, Panda.
Yeah. Never. One bowl, two bowls. No, he needed that one more hit.
Yeah, so he can pocket Musketeer, take it out.
Chusta needs to plant an Elixir Pump or he's gonna lose.
Yeah, there it is.
Prediction pump.
Prediction pump.
Pretty much.
Yeah. Oh, congrats, Royale, Mike. I don't think I've won any prizes from the tournament.
Congrats
before.
To Panda for that. Yeah, well, your cards aren't at tournament standard, so.
Yeah. Still fun. I got close to, like, the low end one once.
Look at that, just like I said, because he was the second, the highest rank, there's no way he would have won more than 30 trophies for that, so.
Yeah, really close though. I haven't seen like 400 in a tournament before, but I haven't been watching them lately, so yeah, these guys are really solid players. Cool decks too. You got the very popular deck, which is Giant Bowler Poison.
Yeah, this one, there's a variation of between the Prince or the Bowler or the Mini P.E.K.K.A.
Or Musketeer.
Or a Musketeer.
Yeah.
But a recurring theme is Elixir Pump, Ice Spirit, Zap, Giant,
and
Mega Minion.
Yeah. So yeah, it's cool seeing these guys use like the Mega Minion. Just came out.
Yeah. I'm kind of excited for this card. It's gonna come out.
What is it?
Should be on Friday.
Friday?
Yeah. I'm kind of tired of seeing all these giants.
Yeah, that'd be cool to see. Yeah, congratulations.
But, not ragging on these guys. It's like. Use what works best, you know? Mm-hmm. It's up to Supercell to kind of control the balance of everything.
And they've done an awesome job, I think. It's like one of the games that's not... I don't feel like one thing's like super overpowered.
At first, when they balanced the Giant, I was kind of like, why did they only nerf it by 5%? But after we saw the Inferno Dragon, it kind of made a little more sense because it's indirectly nerfing that.
Yeah.
So everything kind of ties in together where they try not to directly nerf.
Yeah, because like once you change something, like something else is going to get stronger.
Changes the interactions with all the games.
Yeah. Let's see the top three. Let's see where they're from. Clout, I think. Yeah,
Clout Gaming. Luxia from Clout using the Mega Minion, Prince, Giant.
I like that deck. That was really cool. Great plays, too.
Using the classic Giant Bowler deck with Mini P.E.K.K.A.
Gang one.
Joshua from All Blacks.
2.0.
Using the same Bowler, Giant, Mega Minion.
Yep. Oh, another Prince. Wow. Prince coming out.
Cess had guards in there.
Where's Cess from?
Star Wars. Cess is from extremerules.ph.
Cool.
Star Wars from Adult.
That's a cool name. I like that.
they're all running the same.
Yeah, a lot of Giant Bowler.
Okay, there we go. Now we have something different. Someone without...
Mm-hmm.
With a different kind of tank.
I got Skeletons in there, too. I got Knight.
Yeah, it looks like... you can already tell how Juji plays this game.
Yeah.
He's gonna
split the Musketeer.
He's gonna cycle in the Skeletons and Ice Spirits, just rapidly cycling it to get two pumps on the map. And once he has two pumps, he'll split the Musketeers, send in the Miner on the left side, send in the Knight on the right side, or whatever side makes sense.
Yep.
And just keep building Elixir trades with that, and the Knight just defends against everything for the pump.
Yeah.
Knight, Ice Spirit, Skeletons.
It's a cool deck. It's a cool cycle type deck.
Cycle Elixir pump. Too bad we didn't get to see that, because this is kind of one of my favorite decks where you can split push.
Yeah.
It's a cycle split push.
Cool. But yeah, congratulations to these guys, man. Good work.
That's awesome.
Hour of constant playing. Really tough. But you guys did it. Good prizes, too.
Yeah, so the tournaments are over, and that concludes the stream.
Yeah, that's it for tonight. We got some videos to make.
We have a lot to do.
Got like two on the way. But yeah, congratulations again, and thanks again to MasteryGG. Yeah, just keep posted either, probably on Twitter, probably the best way to find out about when the next stream is, when the next tournament is, kind of thing.
Yeah, Twitter, OJ Every Day is our Twitter. That's when we announce all the tournaments. We'll probably host another one, depending if you guys liked if Mastery spawn, like...
Yeah, well, it depends on the time, right? We got a lot of stuff to do. But yeah, thanks for watching. And congratulations again to everybody.
Yep, everyone played really well for that. It was awesome.
See you guys.
Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for more quality OJ.